We have so many terms in the Poi world that they can get incredibly confusing, but I'm here to help. This is the first installment of a new series of videos that will explain the definition and history of some of the most important Poi terms. Drex here from drexfactor.com, and today we're talking about the versatile cap and its place in the Poi world. Be sure to join my notification squad by hitting that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know exactly when I drop a new video. Before we dive in, I just want to take a moment to give a shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow Toys, LMF Props, Spinballs, and Ultrapoi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these companies by following the links down in the description of this video. Okay, so right out the gate, let's get two things straight. What does CAP stand for and what does it actually mean? CAP is an acronym and it stands for Continuous Assembly Pattern. It comes out of the work of two different Poi spinners way back in 2007. In a thread analyzing the tricks that Poi legend Yuta Imamura was using in a finale performance at Bornfire, French juggler and Poi spinner Damien Boisbouvier coined the term to describe two tricks shown off in the performance that seemed to contain elements of both anti-spin and in-spin Poi tricks. See, anti-spin and in-spin flowers are supposed to be opposites. One involves the hand and Poi moving in opposite directions, and the other involves them going in the same direction. So how could you have a trick that did both? Damien realized that you could do this if you simply didn't complete either trick. That is, what if instead of having your hand complete a flower by going around in a circle, it kept bouncing back and forth along half of the circle? You couldn't get the Poi to stop spinning, so for part of the move, the hand and Poi would be traveling in the same direction, and for part of it, they'd be going in opposite directions. Thus, Damien coined a term for a class of Poi moves that are made by cutting up different patterns and pasting them back together in a different order. The definition of a continuous assembly pattern from the mouth of the man himself? A cap is a cyclic pattern assembled out of two or more elementary patterns iterated one or more times. So obvious question, what exactly is an elementary pattern as Damien referred to? Well, that gets kind of tricky, and it can really depend on who's answering the question. For both myself and Damien, an elementary pattern is something that's mathematical in definition. You can model Poi patterns using parametric functions on a graph, and to both of us, an elementary pattern is anything that you can create by inserting a single number into one of the variables on the graph. So basically, any flower or weave, isolations, extensions, etc. But, and this is a very important distinction, no transitions between them. And this actually opens up an enormous can of worms, because technically, you can claim that any transition between two or more of these tricks that repeats also counts as a cap. Say, for example, that you're doing a 4-beat fountain and you decide to break it up with giants, and you repeat this over and over again. Is this a cap? Well, I would say yes. The concept winds up applying to a lot of things that look nothing like the original trick in the Yuta video. For example, 1.5-beat weaves can be considered caps that combine elements of 3-beat weaves and 2-petal inspin flowers. And the triquetra in Triquetra vs. Pendulum is also very clearly a cap. It's one that's made out of pieces of a box mode 4-petal anti-spin flower and a linear isolation. But to keep things simple, we try to restrict using the term cap only in cases where both the hand changes direction during the course of the move, and only performs pieces of elementary patterns that also count as flowers. The classic case of this is the cap from the Yuta video, which we now refer to as a C cap, because the path the hand follows looks like the letter C. It has a number of variations depending upon whether the hands are together or apart when moving along their path, and of course whether the Poi are spinning in opposites or in the same direction. It also covers a couple different approaches to doing split-time same-direction flowers in wall plane. To do this continuously, you have to be in wheel plane because otherwise your arms will tangle. But if you opt to do these as caps instead, you have the option of either switching back and forth between anti-spin and extension, or switching back and forth between anti-spin and isolation. This latter option is a personal favorite of mine. There's also the strange and exotic S cap, which is more popular in the double staff world, but you do occasionally see it being used by Poi spinners. The idea here is to place two C-shaped hand paths next to each other and move the hand back and forth along the length of both. Typically, this winds up switching back and forth between a triquetra and an extension. A rare and somewhat outdated use for the term is also applied to variations on Zan's diamond, which are sometimes referred to as elliptical caps. The reason for this is that since they're built out of linear extensions, the path of the Poi is more elliptical than circular, and there are many variations that involve switching back and forth between in-spin and anti-spin elements. Since the term Zan's diamond has gained popularity, referring to these as elliptical caps has largely fallen out of favor. Finally, caps found a new life in the Poi spinning framework known as nine-square theory. Now, nine-square theory could be an entire video in and of itself, and I probably will do that at some point, but the Cliff Notes version of it is this. Nine-square theory is the brainchild of Lantern Smith founder and former helicopter pilot Charlie Cushing. Charlie sought to break down flower-based tricks and transitions into a 3x3 grid with points of interest in different squares of the grid. He realized that one of the more interesting properties of C-caps is that they take the poi through multiple combinations of timing and direction. For instance, one of the caps shown in that old Yuta video cycles the poi back and forth between moments when they're in split time opposites and together time opposites. So Charlie grabbed a hold of this property of continuous assembly patterns and came up with a pattern assembled out of, wait for it, continuous assembly patterns. We are getting super meta here, folks. He refers to these patterns as 8-step caps, and they basically exist to let you cycle through whatever timing you want with the poi as you complete a more complex pattern around your body. And just like C-caps themselves, there are loads of timing and direction variations to play with. Cool, so I hope this helped to clear some things up. I'm gonna leave links to some of the things that I referenced in this video down in the description. If you'd like to learn more about caps, including how to do them, you should check out my Beyond the Basics course at my learning site. It covers caps, hybrids, and a whole mess of other cool things that you can do once you get comfortable with your flowers. You can check it out by heading over to learn.drexfactor.com. Before we head out, I just want to put out a quick thank you to all of my awesome supporters on Patreon. Your support is what makes this channel and the videos on it possible. If you'd like to sign up to support the work that I do, please head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi. Thank you in advance. So tell me, what's your favorite cap variant, and what tricks would you like to see me cover in a future explainer video? Let me know down in the comments. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace.